How to use: shake well before using, insert extension tube into nozzle, need my glasses, point extension tube at target location and away from face. That's good to know. Don't spray it in your face. Push button to dispense foam. Apply evenly, avoid dripping and runoff. Okay. Hello, and welcome to Spirit Forest. We are going to tackle these hornets, yellow jackets, wasps, whatever you want to call them. Do you guys remember when I took down my big canvas tent and like Kyla screamed so loud that neighbors came over because they thought somebody was being attacked by a mountain lion? Yeah, she's got a voice on her, it turns out. And then the girl's daddy got stung and he almost like passed out or something. Like he was in the car, he thought he was having an allergic reaction, and it was like all this drama was going on. I mentioned it. Anyways, so they don't want to come back here. Well, the girls are coming back. I keep telling them that the yellow jackets aren't out yet. At least, not that I know of. Now, I am sitting on their nest right now. I know, aren't I smart? No, I have not seen one. It's right behind me. I have not seen one come out of there. So maybe they're still sleeping or they moved. I don't know. But we're going to try this. I got a lot of recommendations from you guys of what to do. So we're going to do this. Okay, so this is a ground nest. Let me show you the nest first before I put this all together. Let me show you the nest. Okay, I was just sitting there. There's the tripod. And come down here to the nest. You can kind of see a little bit, maybe you can see on the camera, that some of it is like really dark, it's old, and some of it looks new. Well, they have dug out. I have stuck these two sticks in there. Oh, I did get a little scared right there. And I think they were starting another one over there on that side. But that is the nest underneath this log. I don't know. I was asking some neighbors what they do. They're planning on digging it out. I'm not going to do that. No, I'm going to use a spray foam, follow the instructions on the can, and we're going to see what happens. Okay, let's see. For ground nesting yellow jackets, using the attached extension tube, which is just taped on. Okay. Spray product directly into holes in ground where yellow jacket activity has been observed. After 24 hours, cover the hole with soil. For best results, spray in the early morning or late evening. It's about 6 o'clock right now. When the yellow jacket activity... Was that just a bee? Okay. Yellow jacket activity is low and most yellow jackets are in the nest. So I haven't seen any of them fly out. And of course, now I'm sitting on it. I just took out those sticks, but I haven't seen any of them. I don't know. So the girls, I have two daughters, for those of you that don't know, and we camp here, and it's my property. And they are scared to death. They did come out here, but it's like they're just waiting for when we leave, and any fly that passes by them, they think is a yellow jacket, and they're freaking out because I am not kidding you. This last fall, record amount of yellow jackets, like everywhere, all over you. It was crazy ridiculous. I don't know. I think at some point there was like 20 of them around me or something. I don't know. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but yeah, don't point at face. I gotta laugh at myself, but I can't see the hole. Okay. Wouldn't that be hilarious? Spray myself as I just made fun of the directions. Okay, we gotta shake it. Do you think they're gonna fly out while I'm spraying this? I have shoes on. I did have like some kind of like flip-flops or sandals on before. I think it's pretty good. I can feel it. It's like foamed up inside the can. Maybe I should, like, just in case. We might dart out to the car. It's very possible. Rocky's in his normal spot, sitting on the deck. Is that good? Okay, tuck this in here. Oh my God, it was probably so loud with the mic. I'm so sorry. Okay. We could do this. I got this. There's no yellow jackets coming out of it yet. Do you guys want a close-up of it? Yeah, I'll give you a close-up so you don't have to see me and my facial expressions as I'm like, ah. That's totally what it's going to be like. Okay, let me move the camera. Okay, do you see the holes? I'm going to point them out for you. One's right there. And, ooh, look, you could see a dead body of a yellow jacket. Oh, my goodness. Look at that thing. I'm not kidding you. They were everywhere. Oh, I should probably shake this again. Okay, we're doing it. Get ready to run. No idea. You stick it in. How far in the hole do you go? Oh, I can keep going. I'm spraying. I have no idea if it's coming out or not. Unless it's filling the hole. Is it coming out? I'm pushing down. It's making noises. Oh my gosh. Okay. This hole must be really big. Holy cow, am I gonna empty this can? How long do we do this for? Spray directly into hole. I'm reading the directions. For best, oh my God, this dust doesn't smell good either. Oh my, it's not coming out. It's just, is it because it's so deep and this is a big hive? I have no idea. How long do we do this for? I'm literally like talking to you, like you're right next to me. I thought it was gonna like be done within seconds and come out of that hole. I mean, I guess I could just empty the can. What else am I gonna do with this can? Rocky, do not come over here. It even has warnings about animals. He's wondering what I'm doing. My fingers are hurting. It has kind of a weird smell. Is this a hole? I don't think. See how that does? Look how that did. So it's like it's foaming. But man, this must be huge in there. I'm not kidding you. There was a ton of them. I'm just gonna keep spraying. Girls, this is for you. What's the purpose of a hornet? Like, what is their purpose? You know, like, in nature, what's their purpose? Shoot, what's our purpose? What's the purpose of a human? Okay, we're not going to go that deep. We're not going that deep and talk right now. Oh my gosh, my hands are hurting. Hopefully you could still see. I'm going to make sure I'm recording. Did I hit record? Yeah, okay. For a minute there, I was like, what if I wasn't recording? I don't know what to do. I'm like half done with this can. What do you think? Do we just empty the can? Do not allow people or pets to contact. Okay, that's fine. What else? Okay, it's just telling me what not to do, and then it's giving me different languages. It doesn't say how long you do it for. Okay. It's coming out. You see that? You see that liquid coming out like that? Maybe I need to shake it more. Ooh, don't let it drip, it said. Don't let it drip. It's dripping. I'm trying to shake it because I just don't see foam. I see more bubbles. You think I'm done? I think I'm done. I don't know. Let me... It's not on this hand. It's on this hand. So I am... I'm sure it's on the can. Okay, and then I'm going to... stick it here. You know who bought this can for me? Was the girl's daddy. Because he's like, I'm not going out there again until you spray that hole. And I was like, okay, okay, I got it for you. You're okay now. So we leave that for 24 hours. Since I'm camping here, I will be here. And then I cover it with dirt. Okay. Let's go wash my hands. I was digging through this thing, and I have another bin on my deck, and I'm like, where's my soap? So it's on this hand. And look what happened to my soap. It turned yellow. I don't, does this stuff expire? I'm trying to remember. I think this is my second bottle that I bought for camping out here. I don't know. Come on. Is it... it's clogged. Of course it is, because I really want to use it right now. That's why it's clogged. And I have nothing to unclog it. Okay. Here we go. No, it's not food, Rox. You see his nose in the corner? I still have my hood up. I'm ready to get out of Dodge if anything happens over there, you know? I didn't see any hornets or anything like that there. I only got so much water. So I think that might take care of it. So this is a multi-part video. What I'm gonna do is, it's still kind of early right now for them. I mean, it's just chilly up here in the mountains. So maybe they haven't come out of like hibernation or something. So I'm recording this video earlier. And we will check it in a few weeks. So this is not a part one. I'm going to show you what the results are at the end. But this is where my faucet would... well, faucet would be nice, wouldn't it? You're not even seeing what I'm doing down here. I'm cleaning them. I think my hand... I love the... oh, no, it doesn't smell that... I used to love the smell of the soap. Does it go bad? Does camping soap go bad? Because it has all like natural ingredients? I don't know. Kind of smells a little bit like toothpaste and lavender together. Oh, there we go. Oh, freedom, freedom. Okay. So I'm gonna get going. And then I'll see you in a couple weeks, but you will see me in a couple seconds as we come back here, and I'll be in a different outfit, and we check on this whole hornet nest to see if any of the hornets are flying out of it. That's what I want to know. I'll see you in a couple seconds. Hello. It has been about a month has gone by since I have sprayed for my hornets, and I wanted to give you an update on that and how my hornet situation is doing here. I think what I'll do is I'm just gonna grab the camera here and we're just gonna point it where the hole was at. So it was right there, and then I did put some dirt over it and no hornet activity at all. However, we got something else going on here. I don't know what's going on there, but That might be carpenter ants. I do have a lot of carpenter ants here. That's a different issue. We're talking about our hornets. So I think it worked. I really do. I think it worked. There's nothing, no activity whatsoever going on from this nest. So you might be asking, am I seeing a lot of hornets around? Yes, I do see some of them. Not a ton, not like it was before, but I do see some. I probably see about like 5 to 6 a day, I would say. So there is another nest somewhere here at Spirit Forest, and I don't know where it is. And every time I walk around, I do look, or if I see a hornet, I try to see which direction they might be flying in. Let's see, I want to tell you a story about a hornet here. I have never been stung by a hornet until last night. Yeah, never been stung by a bee or anything. I have been able to avoid them. So I am staying the night here last night, and I was in my tent, and I had my friend with me too. And we got into the tent, and they looked up, and they're like, there's a hornet in here. And you could see it inside the tent, you know, and it was flying around. And I was like, it seemed really calm. It wasn't like aggressive or anything like that. I opened the door and zipped my door for the hornet to go out. And my friend said, yes, it went out. And I'm like, I didn't see it go out. Did it go out? You know, and he was like, yeah, it's out. So don't worry about it. And so then I was like, okay. So I zip it back up and I'm laying there and we're just like chatting. And I don't know, maybe like an hour went by, something like that, about an hour. And I just kind of moved my back a little bit. I'm in my sleeping bag and I got stung right there in the middle of my back. Never been stung before. I didn't know what it was. I was like, holy cow. I like jumped out of my sleeping bag and I'm like, something's in my sleeping bag, you know? And then I saw it. There was it's a big one too, a big hornet. And I'd never been stung by one. So now I actually have an experience of what it's like to be stung by a hornet. And I'm going to explain it. But so there I am like freaking out, you know, and I'm like, okay. And I'm like, let's get this out. My friend, he's freaking out, you know, he's like, oh my God. So we get it out of my sleeping bag, open the window again, and we actually physically watch it go out. I made sure I watched that thing go out. So so ironically, I spent the night with a hornet and it stung me in the back, which is really weird because I must have been laying on this hornet for like an hour because we were watching something from my phone and I was laying in the same position for a while and it must have just been in the right position where it couldn't sting me. Man. So what was it like being stung by a hornet? Well, I was kind of like, at first I was, cause I seen my daughter's reaction and I seen my daughter's daddy's reaction and I thought it was going to be a lot worse. Now, I thought that was a hornet. I really did. Did you hear it? I think that was a fly, but first I was a little jumpy right then. Anyways, I did feel the sting, you know, it did sting. It feels like you're burnt. Like you just, if you touched a hot pan or something like that and you got burnt, you know what I mean? You're like, ow. And that's still kind of like a kind of a sting, kind of a burn. Now I must have a high tolerance for pain. Well, I did deliver Madison and I almost died. So, and I was told at the hospital that I have a very high tolerance for pain. So, it didn't bother me. It really didn't. Like, it was almost like, again, I touched a pot, it was really hot, and you're like, ow, ow. And then within 2 minutes, it was gone. Like, my friend was like, are you okay? Now, it swelled up. It did swell up on my back. I had like a welt that was, I don't know if you can see, like that big, something like that, and it was like red around it. But I was okay after 2 minutes. I didn't feel it anymore. I don't feel it today. I was fine. But my daughter's reaction, like she cried for like 3 hours straight, you know, and the girl's daddy, like he started hyperventilating and was just like really freaking out and almost passed out, you know. I'm like, what are you guys?
No, I'm guessing maybe there's different kinds of stings because this really wasn't that bad. It really wasn't as bad as, like, I've seen people, like, get stung and, like, really freak out. But I have a subscriber of mine, Tara, came on my Wilderness on Wheels event, and they got stung, like, twice or three times on that event. And they came up to me, it was like, I got stung multiple times. And I'm like, are you okay? And they were just fine. So, Tara, you and I have a high tolerance for pain. We can deal with it. These other people, I don't know. Not to say that that was something that was enjoyable. It was not enjoyable, you know, not at all. But I just wanted to tell you guys that I actually got yesterday my first sting from a bee or a hornet and stuff. And so it was like, and my friend was nervous that I might have like an allergic reaction because I'm allergic to some things. And usually that I heard that it doesn't happen on your first time. It happens like the second time you get stung. So let's just cross my fingers that the second time, which will probably happen because I have a lot of hornets out here, the second time I don't have any reaction. So thank you guys for watching so far. It looks really good. No hornets in my hornet nest next to my tent, and I will be looking around. I still have like a, what is it, like a quarter of the can left, and I have it in one of my bins here, so I am ready for when this happens again. So thanks for watching, and I will see you on my next video. Bye-bye.